A group of visionary women formed the Childhood League in 1945 with a simple but profound mission: to help children in need. To begin doing that, the League operated a daycare called the Jacob Hare Home. Childhood League President Marion Fulton wrote to the Council of Social Agencies to ask how the League could help address the increased need for quality care and education for young children. As a result of that communication, the League expanded its reach by opening Sullivan Gardens Nursery School on Columbus's west side, setting the tone for the organization as innovative and ahead of its time. In 1949, the League held the first Merry-Go-Round Gala, which contributed significantly to the League's budget.
I enjoyed it so much, and we got to meet the couples, and we formed really close friendships with those women and their husbands. It was like a sorority group, really, really close friends that I've kept throughout my life.
In 1950, the League broke ground on a new nursery school on South 18th Street. 1950 is also the year Jane Evans Zartman joined the League.
But I think the move to South 18th Street was the biggest event that I recall. Moving the personnel and the children and making that into a real daycare center for children. That was a really big thing in the city of Columbus, I think.
In 1961, President Kennedy appointed a panel of experts to determine how the federal government could support people with developmental delays. Those recommendations led to legislation, which was passed by Congress and signed by President Kennedy in 1963. That allowed increased federal funding for states to update their programs for helping people with developmental delays. 1964 was a milestone year as the Childhood League opened its first class specifically dedicated to children with developmental delays. That's also the year the Childhood League became the Childhood League Center. The number of families the organization impacted continued to rise. By 1980, the center had graduated more than 500 students to kindergarten. After a successful capital campaign by the League, the center's new building opened across from Nationwide Children's Hospital in 1990. In 1993, the center began its early intervention program, a key expansion of services, and now included infants and toddlers with special needs. And that need was growing.
And there were so many kids that needed served, like thousands, right? So how could we build a strategic plan that would allow us to serve more students? And one of the ways that we did that was by putting on the Fulton Wing.
In 2000, the Marion Mills Fulton Pathway to Early Intervention Wing opened, allowing the center to expand its programming for children birth to age 3 by 66%. In 2001, two major developments laid the groundwork for a long-lasting expansion of services provided by the center. First, the center was selected as one of 12 providers to implement Ohio's Early Start program in Franklin County, now known as Help Me Grow. That same year, a breakthrough intervention for young children with autism, a parent-implemented intervention called the Play Project, was developed. In 2016, the center became the first licensed Play Project center in the nation, making it a leader in serving children with autism. In 2009, the board moved from being all League members to integrating League members and other community leaders. This change enabled the center to expand its ability to raise awareness and funds for its mission, while also increasing the impact in the community.
It was the right thing to do. It was so much easier to engage the business community at a higher level, meaning large corporations.
The new board configuration played a major role in the center's ability to raise money for a new building, with every indoor and outdoor space meticulously designed with students of all needs and abilities in mind. The building opened to students in 2017.
And being able to expand and serve yet even more children than we were serving in our previous building is really important to us. It's the impact we make in the community. The more kids that we can welcome and the more families that we can welcome into this building to experience our services, the better off that family is, the better off that child is, and ultimately, the better off our community is.
The center's mission to change the trajectory of children's lives continues today, thanks to the invaluable contributions of groups like the League.
I think it's important to remember all of the women that came before us and sort of the path that they paved. And you know, they were so dedicated to this cause, and so are we right now.
The board.
We wanted our board to be diverse. We wanted our board to have gender parity. We wanted our board to be come from industries that we didn't have an arm in before. And we wanted to bring those collective minds together to really drive the mission of what the center could look like in the future.
The council
called upon us of, hey, we really need your help in expanding awareness from a male perspective. And that's wonderful. I think that that's great.
And the incredible staff who give answers and hope to children and families from birth through 5 years old. And advocates like you who are giving of their time and their treasure to keep the center running at full speed and the kids on the path to living their best lives. The center's history is just part of its continuing legacy. What truly separates it is its impact the center has on children, their families, and the community.